I am Dr. Gaurav Verma. In this video, we will learn about Fermat numbers. All we have a definition of Fermat number. A Fermat number is an integer of the form 2 raised to power n plus 1. It is a Fermat number. Any number of this type is called Fermat number, where n is a non-negative integer. If this fn is a prime, it is said to be a Fermat prime. So if we put value of n is equal to 0, we get 2 raised to power 2 raised to 0 plus 1. It is a 3. It is the first Fermat prime, f0. If we take n is equal to 1, we get 5. If we take n is equal to 2, we get 17. If we take n is equal to 3, we get 257. These all are prime numbers and it is known as Fermat prime. Fermat numbers may or may not be a prime numbers. It may be a composite number. Here f5 is not a prime number. First four numbers f1, f2, f3, f4 are prime numbers, but f5 is not a prime number. So we have a theorem. Fermat number f5 is divisible by 641. It means it is a composite number. We have to prove it now. How to prove it? Let's start. Let us take a is equal to 2 raised to power 7, which is equal to 128, and take b is equal to 5. Now take expression 1 plus ab that can be written as 1 plus. By using the value of a and b, we get 641. This is expression we have made for 641. Now take this expression. Now simplify this one by taking b common, using the value of a 128 and using the value of b cube 125 here, we get 1 plus 3b. Again using the value of b here, we get 16, and we can write 16 as a 2 raised to power 4. Now it means 2 raised to power 4 can be written as 1 plus ab minus b raised to 4. Now we have f5. We know that Fermat numbers are the form 2 raised to power n plus 1. So here n we have used 5. This expression is 32. It is written as 2 raised to power 32 plus 1. We can break this 32 into two parts, 4 plus 28. In multiplication, it is written like this. Now 2 raised to 4 is kept as, whereas 2 raised to power 28 is broken like 7 into 4. Now we know that 2 raised to power 7 is a value of a. So use here a raised to 4. Now 2 raised to 4, we have already proved for it. This is value of this. So use value of 2 raised to 4 here. Now we have this expression. Now multiply this part with these two numbers and multiply a4 with only this number. We have this 1 plus 1. Further, on simplification, we get this term and last two terms combining this term. Now on this we will apply factorization 1 minus a square b square whole square. This will be gives us identity a minus x minus square y minus y square is equal to x minus y x plus y. So this part is simplified like this. Now take common from the whole part 1 plus ab. So we get two factors of the expression f5, and we know that what is 1 plus ab? 1 plus ab we have already solved. This is 641. Sorry. For using this, we get f5 value for this. It means 641 is divide f5. In this way, we have simply proved that f5 is our Fermat number, which is composite. Moving to the next theorem, for n greater than equal to 2, if we have n greater than equal to 2, the last digit of every Fermat number is 7. After n greater than 2, if f3, if f4, f5, each Fermat number last digit is 7, so we have to show that Fn is congruent to 7 modulo 10. It is also written like this. How? Now we have to prove this thing. We know that this is a Fermat number 2 raised to power 2n plus 1. If we take subtract 1 from both sides, we can also modify the result like this. We have to prove this result. We prove this result by using n is equal to 2. We will method use mathematical induction. First of all, take n is equal to 2 in this one equation. Take n is equal to 2 in this one equation. So we get 2 raised to power 2. It is 2 raised to power 4, 16. If we take modulo 10, it becomes 6 modulo 10. So it is proved for 6 modulo 10. If we assume that the result is true for n is equal to k, so this step okay. Now we have to prove the result for n is equal to k plus 1. So from step number 2, we have this step, because we can write 6 modulo 10 like this, 6 plus 10 mod n. Scaling on both sides, we get this one. Here it power when get added, because it becomes 2k. Here we have a whole scale entity a square b square 2ab, but taking modulo 10, this is 0, this is 0, we get only 6 modulo 10. In this way, we have result proved for n is equal to k plus 1, when we can say that 2 raised to power 2n is congruent to 6 modulo 10, or fn is congruent to 7 modulo 10. So in this theorem, we have learned how to prove a Fermat number's last digit is 7 when n is greater than 2. Thank you very much for watching my video. If you like my videos, please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.